So I'm doing this video in order to show you guys how murky and deceptive things are regarding the 3DO recording things about it. So as you see here, there's a little excerpt here. This is Gordon Bellamy, which is an African-American game programmer. In the Netflix documentary, High Score, it claims that him and the team he worked on were the first ones to insert African-Americans into the game. Now, the reason why this is not, I guess you could say important. The reason why this is important is because, well, this is a lie. It says here, Madden NFL 95 for the Genesis reflected, you know, the diversity on the teams, including showing, you know, two players on the cover. Whereas John Madden, there's a link here, I'm going to click on that in a second, had depicted all players as white. That's the main thing right there, all players. Partly because the technology at the time made it difficult. Let's click on John Madden here. Oh, interesting. John Madden Football for the 3DO. So this came out in May of 94. If we go up here to Madden 95, this came out in November 94. So 7 month difference. So now here is the European cover of John Madden Football. Here is screenshot gameplay of a game developed in 92, started development in 92. As you can tell, came out, again, this is a almost seven month difference in release. And as you can see, this game accurately represents what the NFL looked like with an actual NFL roster. So there's the NFL logo there. There's clearly NFL licensing in this. Why do we have to lie about history to virtue signal about, I mean, it's just ridiculous. Anyone with a brain can look at this and just admit this is incredibly careless with the handling of history. This is mishandling historical things in the game industry. Now, not that it matters. However, when I see a lie, a blatant lie, I'm going to call it out regardless. This is a lie. John Madden on the 3DO had a real NFL roster, and which, as you can see on the cover, NFL, and it had the players to represent the NFL. So there you have it.